Well, hello from the Flamingoland Stadium in Scarborough, in front of the famous Scarborough Football Club gates. And I'm here with the Scarborough Athletic Chairman, Trevor Ball. Well, firstly, what a night at Colwyn Bay. A long journey for the fans and the players and all the officials. But we came out with 3 points.
It was a fantastic night, a very long night. I got home at 4 a.m. It was one of those days where we hoped we would get a victory, but we couldn't count it because the Colwyn Bay are a super side. Absolutely fantastic night.
And the last time we spoke to you doing one of these videos, we were having a bit of a rough patch, but since then, loads of wins, just a draw in there as well, but it's been a real turnaround and the momentum is with Scarborough towards the end of the season, which is exactly what we need.
Yeah, five wins and a draw since we last spoke, and that's good at any time of the season, but this time of the season is absolutely crucial. What it's done is inject a feel-good factor right around the club, because we really believe we can do this now. Steve tells me he's not interested in this third place. He doesn't want to go third place, he wants to go second. He said after the very first match of the season that if he was 3 points behind South Shields at the end of the season, he'd be really, really happy. And that's where we could be. So the opportunity's there. So it's second place we're going for. So, yeah, nearly there.
Nearly there, yeah. So just a few games left, including just the one away game. And, I mean, there's a real feeling there's going to be a lot of Borough fans making the journey to Colne. And you want as many as possible to cheer on the Borough. You want to make it feel like a home game.
Absolutely. All to say to our fans is remember Brighouse. We were all there. 800 of us travelled to Brighouse to see his virtually guaranteed promotion. And we're in a very similar position this time. We spoke to the people at Colne today. We said there might be 400 people going. They said, wow. They said that'll be one of the biggest away attendances we've ever had in our history. But come on, let's double that. Let's have 800 there like Brighouse. That's what we really want.
Yeah. I mean, everyone remembers that game. And you can imagine the atmosphere if that many Borough fans travel over. It will really help the players, won't it? It always does.
Yeah, the players all tell me to Amanda that it really makes a difference. See, players that play at this level aren't used to travelling support. Most clubs have half a dozen people, maybe a couple of dozen people that go to away games. So, there was 100 fans went all the way to Colwyn Bay on a Tuesday night. So they find it quite unbelievable, and it really matters to them that they perform for the fans.
And then after that, a couple of home games to finish off the season. Who knows what position we will be in as each of those games come along?
Well, we're very lucky because when we lined up to play Glossop on Tuesday night, Hyde United will only have one game left. So we'll know exactly what we need to do if second is still our ambition. We could be promoted by then, who knows. But I think there'll be an awful lot riding on the Tuesday night game.
Yeah, and then of course, the big finale on Saturday, and it is an all ticket.
Yes.
And by the way ticket sales are going, that was a good decision. There are still tickets left, but they're selling very well.
Yeah, we've sold just short of 1,200 tickets already, so if you want your ticket, get buying them now. It's really to help us on the day as much as anything. We do believe that we can get 2,000 people to come to that game. Very momentous game for another reason. It's Ossett Albion's final ever game as a football club because they're merging with Ossett Town to form Ossett United. They've asked us for 150 tickets, so there'll be some away supporters here, and we need to make sure that we make them very welcome, because it'd be an emotional day for them, because sadly we know what it's like to lose a football club. So we'll be making some presentations to them on the pitch before, and we're going to look after their board of directors and give them a meal before the game. So we're trying to make it special for them as well, but really I want it to be special for us. I want it to be a promotion party, you know. Let's the players will be doing a lap of honour, whatever happens at the end of the game, and let's fill the clubhouse afterwards and have a few beers.
I think you mentioned that promotion went way too much, Trevor, but anyway.
It's what I want.
I know, it's what we all want. And then after the season, I mean, it doesn't finish there, does it? We'll come to the cup final in a moment, but we've got the Player of the Year awards. Talk us through that, when they are, and how people can come on to that.
The Player of the Year, we're holding those at the Crown Spa Hotel, and that's on the Saturday prior to the North Riding Senior Cup final. Tickets are £30. We want as many supporters there as possible, so you can buy them online, you can buy them in the club shop.
Great. And then it's the North Riding Senior Cup final. And, you know, Scarborough Athletic playing at the Riverside Stadium against the Middlesbrough side as well. And that's going to be a special night for the club, isn't it?
It's very special for me, and it's very special to a good friend of mine, Fred Furman, another of our directors, because when we were growing up, the North Riding Senior Cup was massive for Scarborough FC. Going back to the late 60s, early 70s, the North Riding Senior Cup was what originally got me hooked on Scarborough Football Club, because we regularly won that trophy. So to see the old club and the new club both with the names on the same trophy, that would be very, very special.
Yeah. So again, you want as many people to travel to that game. It's a big stadium to fill. I'm sure we won't fill it, but it'll be good to get a load of Scarborough fans hopefully celebrating a promotion at the Riverside that night.
Interestingly, I've been in a meeting today with the North Riding FA, and they're expecting more Scarborough fans and Middlesbrough fans on the night, but that's okay. We'll create some atmosphere. We'll be selling tickets starting at the Glossop game. It's only £6 for adults and £3 for concessions. But we'd like as many people as possible to buy tickets before they travel up to Middlesbrough, because they're a bit flashy in those. They've got electronic turnstiles, so if you don't, you'll have to queue to buy a ticket and then queue at a turnstile, so it will save you time.
Great. Well, it's going to be really exciting. Few weeks, isn't it? I mean, and then hopefully you can just relax over the summer. You won't be though, will you? You'll be thinking about next season. You probably already are.
Yeah, we're already well on with planning for next season. We're hoping to be in a position at the fans forum on the Friday night before the Ossett game to release details of some ground improvements and talk to people about how we want to improve the ground over the coming years. Not do it all immediately, but how we're going to do that. So we'll be working on that over the summer. And of course we want to sign the best players and all that sort of thing, so it's going to be a very busy summer.
Great. Well done for what a great year it's been so far, but a great season, and here we are, we're nearly there. Okay, thanks very much for your time, Trevor.
Thanks, buddy. Cheers.